Nikolai Kondratiev was a predominant Russian economist of the early 20th century. Born in 1892 into a peasant family, Kondratiev worked hard to become a student of the prestigious St. Petersburg University, where he did not go on to captain the ice hockey team. Instead, Kondratiev took the nerdy path of economics, and after finishing university, he tried his hand at Russian politics. After his short political career, he then founded the Russian Institute of Conjuncture in 1920, where he wrote several publications, including his Kondratiev Wave Theory. However, his work and influence began to upset Joseph Stalin, who took Kondratiev's opinions as criticism of his government. Stalin accused him of being a traitor and had Kondratiev imprisoned for 8 years. After his release, Kondratiev opted to publish more material, which led to him being arrested again and sentenced to a further 11 years jail. However, prior to beginning this sentence, Stalin instead had him executed by a firing squad. It was a sad end to the life of one of the few economists who cited innovation as the backbone for economic growth. Another economist to identify this trend was Joseph Schumpeter, widely regarded as the second best economist in the world in the early 20th century. Born in 1883 in Trieste, Austria, which is now part of the Czech Republic, Schumpeter's father died while he was still young, and this led to him and his mother relocating to the bright lights of Vienna, where he could not be distracted by the silliness of Rob Schneider's movies. This paid off, and Schumpeter became a student at the University of Vienna, where he did a PhD. Shortly after finishing his studies, he published his famous theory of economic development and business cycles, before chairing a bank, which eventually sank in the Depression and led him bankrupt. He returned to academics, and after brief spells of teaching about Europe, he traveled to the US, where he taught at Harvard for 2 years before returning home. Then, as the Nazis began expanding their influence on Europe, Schumpeter decided to return to the US and resume teaching at Harvard, staying until he died in 1950.